Hello guys and welcome back to a new video. In this video I'll be teaching how you can detect and draw contours around an image or a video. So in this particular video I'll be dealing with only images, but you can extend that to video feeds as well. So let's get started. So first of all, detecting and drawing contours requires three or maybe four important steps. So the first step is converting your RGB image into a grayscale image, right? Second step is thresholding that image. So what I mean by thresholding is converting all the pixels in that image to either white or black. So how this is advantages is that whenever you convert every pixel to either white or black, we can form boundaries, right? Because the contour function that we will use to detect looks for the similar intensity of pixels, and if they are similar, it forms a boundary. So converting everything to either white or black forms same intensity pixels that will help in boundary creation, right? So that's the second step. After converting to grayscale, you threshold it. After thresholding, you use the contours cv2.find contours function to detect the contours, and then lastly use the draw contours function, right? So in this video I'll be giving a short coding tutorial on how you can find contours of any image. So we'll start by first of all importing the library, so that is import cv2. Next up I'll be reading my image, so image is cv2.imread, and if I see the file name, I've already got the file name with me, the path basically. So I'll use a sample image of a boat, and I have also got other images, but let's use the boat one first. Okay, so use, and I'll just write the image here. You can copy it as well, but I've got it memorized now, so it's all good. Copying is definitely much more easier, the file path, but it's fine, it's not a big file path. And let's just say I use boat.jpg, right? So I've read my image using the cv2.imread. Now our first step was converting it to grayscale, so I'm using the cv2.convertColor. My source is my image, and I'll be using cv2.color and bgr to gray, right? So img_gray is my grayscale image. Now next up I need to threshold it, right? So red, thresh are the values that are going to be returned using the threshold function. So cv2.threshold, my source is my gray image now, so I am be inputting image_gray. My threshold value, let's just say, is 150. My max value is 255. And let's just say I use the binary, because we need either white or black, right? So cv2.thresh_binary. Now after thresholding, use the contour find contour function, and the value that will it will return is contours and hierarchy, and I'll use cv2.findContours. Now I need to find my contours on my thresholded image, so thresh is my image, and I'll use the retrieval tree mode, and the method used will be cv2.chain_approx_none. Okay, so there are many modes and methods available. You can feel free to toggle and mix and match and see what all results you obtain, but for now I'll be using the retrieval tree and chain approx none. So next up, after doing this, I'll just create a copy of duplicate of my image. So image_copy equal to image.copy. After doing this, I'll draw my contours, and I want to draw my contours on my duplicate image. So image_copy and contours. My contour index is -1. My color, let's just say I want green color, so 0, 255, 0. I need to put a comma here. My color is green. Say I want my thickness as 2 and line type as cv2.color line underscore AA. Okay, cool. Now after drawing contours, I'll just use the cv2.imshow to show the output. That's the window name, and my image that I want to show is image underscore copy, right? Because this is the image we have drawn our contours on. I'll add a wait key and delay is 0, and I'll destroy all windows, right? So if I run this, you can see that this is the image of a boat, and every boundary on it is marked by the green color, right? Because I use the 0 255 0, that corresponds to green as my color to mark the contours. Now you can see that not everything has been marked, because you can see that the boundary around this anchor on the boat has not been marked. This is because we've used the different modes and methods. So if you would use something else, you might see that this has also been covered, right? So I'm not going to dwell into the details of changing the color and all. It's just simple, you toggle around the pixel value. And for, I'll just show a different example as well. So I'll give another image to see how it works. Racket.jfif. And if I run this as well, you can see that everything around this racket has been you can see that it's been marked in green, basically every boundary, right? So that's how this works. And if you want to incorporate this for a video feed, you just run a while loop. So while true, then you get every frame using the capture, cv2.capture, and then using that frame as an image, you perform these steps as it is, right? So video feeds is just an extension to images, and it is very easy. I would like all of the viewers to try that as a homework, and if you have any queries, drop them in the comment section below. I'll be happy to address them. So that's it for this video. If you like the content, make sure to like the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on the bell icon to stay notified whenever I drop more videos. And you can follow me on Twitter or LinkedIn. I frequently post about computer vision or machine learning there. So you can stay connected with me there, and I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye bye.